Hello friends, this is Dr. Alsop again, and we are going to discuss the nerves we need to identify for the parotid gland and submandibular triangle session. So let's get started. All right, let's get our bearings in regards to this view and depth of dissection. So we are looking at a lateral view. This is going to be anterior. This will be posterior. And you can see that this is a relatively superficial dissection because the platysma muscle is present, and you can see almost all of the parotid gland, and we're really going to focus on this parotid gland region to find some of the nerves. You can see a small nerve branch extending superiorly, nestled between the superficial temporal vein and superficial temporal artery. This is the auriculotemporal nerve, which is a branch of the mandibular division of the trigeminal nerve, or often we just refer to that as V3. This nerve is mostly an afferent nerve, serving the regions around the temporomandibular joint, which would be in this region, anterior superior to the ear, the external acoustic meatus, but it also transmits postganglionic parasympathetic fibers to the parotid gland from the otic ganglion, with those preganglionics originating in the glossopharyngeal nerve or cranial nerve 9. So there's a lot going on in this small nerve. Also extending kind of out all over the place from the peripheries of the parotid gland, you can see these branches of the facial nerve. And it is fairly robust in terms of the number of branches that you have. We aren't going to get into the specific names quite yet of these branches of the facial nerve or cranial nerve 7. We will do that in the next session, but we do want you to be aware that these are the facial nerve branches, and you can see them pretty clearly heading towards some of these muscles of facial expression. So it makes sense that these would be branches of the facial nerve. Now, looking at an inferior lateral view with a good amount of the parotid gland removed, you can see the trunk of the facial nerve right here, where it is exiting the stylomastoid foramen. You can even see the styloid process right here. The trunk will fairly quickly divide into the temporofacial division and the cervicofacial division. So the temporofacial will be the more superior division, the cervicofacial will be the more inferior division. Then it will branch into those five main branches of the facial nerve that we'll talk about in the face session. Now, a little review. I want you to try to identify the superior laryngeal nerve in this image. Pause if you need a bit more time to think your way through this structure. I always try to think back to what is the superior laryngeal nerve a branch of. Hint, it might tell you right over here. And if you're ready to move on, let's try to locate that. So your superior laryngeal nerve is going to be right up in this region. It is a branch of the vagus nerve, and it typically branches superior to the carotid bifurcation, which you can see right here. It is going to quickly divide into the internal branch and the external branch. So you can see that this internal branch is going to continue, and it will pierce through the thyrohyoid membrane with that superior laryngeal artery. That internal branch will afferently supply the laryngeal region superior to the vocal folds. And then you can pick back up again in terms of the external branch, which will provide motor or efferent innervation to the cricothyroid muscle as well as the inferior pharyngeal constrictor. And you can see that cricothyroid right here. All right, so hopefully that was a nice review. If you struggled with this, this is a good indication that you need to spend a bit more time reviewing those nerves from the larynx and pharynx session. Lastly, in this session, we are getting one of our first glimpses at the hypoglossal nerve, or cranial nerve 12, not around the cranial base. So you can see it here running between the facial artery and the lingual artery. And you can see it diving deep to the mylohyoid muscle. This nerve provides efferent innervation to almost all extrinsic and intrinsic muscles of the tongue, excluding the palatoglossus muscle. All right, so these are all the nerves we are identifying in this session. Please take time to review on your own and test yourself on these structures, and if any questions arise after that, please feel free to reach out to me. Thank you for your time.